Okay, students, now in this part we are going to understand Java compilation process. So we write a source program, that is the program which we write in English, which is understood by us, and that is compiled into bytecode. Now we are going to use three machines. One is Windows based, one is Unix, and one is Macintosh. So if you compile that Java program for all the three machines, it is going to produce the same bytecode. And before it reaches the machine, it has to go through JVM, that is Java Virtual Machine. So each bytecode is using JVM now, entering into JVM, which is a virtual machine. Now this virtual machine is not bothered what type of operating system is used by the computer. So it has its own operating system. That is what we say, it has its own platform. Now this JVM is converted to native executable code by JIT. That JIT is just-in-time compiler, which is in the JVM. So different three machines, same bytecode for all. JVM is converted into native executable machine code for different machines. So this is what is the Java compilation process. Now we come to characteristics of Java. Vora, write once, run anywhere. You have to write it once and you can run it on as many machines as you want. Then lightweight code. No huge coding is required. Security. It offers many enhanced security features. WOP language, that is object-oriented programming language. That means it is very near to the real-world objects. Platform independent. Now in this diagram you can see that it produces its own code, that is bytecode, and that is for JVM, which is same for all the machines. So that is why it is not bothered whether it is Windows or it is Unix or it is Mac operating system. So that is why we say it is platform independent. So you just have to learn the characteristic like this, not in details. Just it is Vora, lightweight code, security, WOP language, and it is platform independent. Thank you.